Lately, I've been learning more about watersheds, and I'm starting to realize that my house and my yard are kind of like their own mini watershed. The roof would be the top of the watershed. Right now, rain collects on my roof, travels down this pipe and underground to the street, and then it makes its way to my local creek and eventually to the Tualatin River. We get a lot of rain here, so a rain garden is a perfect way to capture some of that rain and keep it on my property. Rain gardens are really great for watersheds because they help slow and absorb rainwater, which in turn helps reduce flooding downstream and also filters out pollutants before they get to rivers, lakes, and creeks. Plus, they're pretty nice to look at as a landscaping option. I did a little research and got in touch with Dennis O'Connor of Habitat Concepts, and he came out to my house just to check things out a little bit, make sure my property will work well with a rain garden. First, we walked around the house together and tried to identify where water is currently running off after it lands on my property. We noticed a few gutter downspouts coming off the roof that could be pretty ideal locations to route water into a rain garden. And there's one downspout in particular right here next to an area of my yard that I really wanted to redo anyway. And luckily, it happens to be fed by a pretty large portion of the roof. After talking to Dennis and doing some reading, I figured out how to calculate my roof's runoff area, which helped me determine how to size my rain garden. Lastly, we did a soil infiltration test right in the middle of where I want my rain garden to be, just to make sure that the soil here can handle the amount of water coming off my roof. It turns out I've got a lot of clay in my soil, which is pretty common in the Tualatin River watershed. So during construction, Dennis is gonna add some soil amendments like compost and mulch, just to make the soil a little more spongy so that water can infiltrate more quickly. After I completed all those steps, I started tracing out the perimeter of my rain garden and tried to think about any hazards I should be avoiding. Dennis had encouraged me to site my rain garden on a bit of a slope, just to make sure that the point at which water flows in is going to be higher than the point at which it naturally flows out. I had to make sure that the outer edge of my rain garden will be at least 2 feet from my foundation. Now, if I had a basement, I would need the outer edge to be at least 6 feet away from my foundation, just to keep everything dry. Then I made sure to call the utility notification center at 811 at least 2 business days before I started digging. This is actually an Oregon law, and it makes sure that I don't hit any important underground gas lines or other utility infrastructure during construction. After I finished delineating my rain garden boundary and digging out the main bowl to form the berm, I gave Dennis a call to come back out to my property because I wanted him to make sure I was digging to the right depth, and I thought I could use a little more insight on how my rain garden's gonna work. Oh, here he comes.
Hey, Dylan.
Hey, Dennis.
See you again.
How are you?
Good.
Good.
Your garden's looking great so far.
Oh, thanks. I was just finishing up the berm this morning. Would you mind checking the dimensions? I want to make sure I got everything right.
No, let's go check it out.
Great, thanks. Right about here?
Right there, Dylan. Perfect. 11 feet.
Okay.
Then we'll measure the width. 4 feet.
Great.
And then the depth.
That's about 11 inches.
This is perfect.
Okay.
For all the water that's going to hit the roof and come down here. Next, we want to add rock to improve infiltration, and topsoil and compost to provide nutrients for the new plants.
All right.
Okay, now we're going to lay down the filter fabric. And then the next step is to add the larger cobble. Now go for the medium. Perfect. And then the medium to the little. And then this is the pea gravel.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. And now we're ready for planting.
Oh, perfect. I got all these plants you recommended, but I'm not sure which ones go where.
Okay. Well, most of the plants on that list were native to the Willamette Valley, and a few were pollinator plants to attract butterflies and bees and that sort of thing.
Right.
So let's look at the dry ones. You have two. You have a saltbush, and you have manzanita.
Okay.
And these both like it dry, so we'll be putting those on the outside areas of this basin. And then the wet sedges, the wetland plants, will go down in this basin. These both can be saturated in underwater for a period of time, and that's why they'll be suited for this.
How's that, Dennis?
Perfect.
All right, well, we got all the plants in. Is there anything else?
We're gonna disconnect the downspout.
Great, let's do it.
Okay.
All right, well, I feel like it's looking pretty good. Is there anything I need to know about taking care of this rain garden going forward?
Yes, it's pretty straightforward. You want to make sure that you water, and after 3 or so years, have a look. You may need to water less because they're natives,
okay. And
they'll get adapted. You want to control the non-native invasive weeds.
Okay.
You don't want English ivy taking off in your yard, and you also want to put mulch down. and do that every year to retain moisture and prevent weed growth.
Thank you so much. You've been an enormous help. I really appreciate it.
Okay. And
can't wait to see how this thing works when it rains.
It'd be great. And if you need any more information, you can check out the website at tualatinswcd.org.
Okay, I will.
Nice to meet you.
Thanks, Dennis.